Hi friends. So we've often heard, be authentic. Let's practice authentic leadership. But what does it really mean? And I'll be very frank over here. For several years, I found it hard to understand when someone told me it's important to be authentic and be an authentic leader. It used to confuse me. But over the years, I figured out all they were trying to say was, be comfortable the way you are and be more focused on being effective. So, authentic leadership is really about being confident and comfortable the way you are and more focused on results and outcomes that you want to achieve in your working or dealings with people. And I want to give you a few examples of authentic leaders that we can all relate to or we've heard of. Let me first start off with some Indian people. You know, we are all Indians. English is not our first language. Yet, a lot of us develop a complex of not speaking good English, and we let that affect our confidence so much that we stop being effective at work or while talking. Let me tell you something. It's not really important when you're standing and addressing people of what accent you're speaking in, or if your English is 100% in compliance with the Oxford Dictionary or with the British. No, it's not. You just need to get your message across. Let's look at Lalu Prasad Yadav. I know it brings smiles and giggles when you think of him, but just think of him as an orator. How many times has he stood on the stage and not been able to deliver a clear message? He's always very clearly communicated whatever he wanted. Let's look at Mahatma Gandhi. Did he wear a certain kind of wear just to fit in? He was himself. He was very comfortable the way he was. He was very tolerant. That's what authentic leadership also is about. He was tolerant of people around him, no matter what they were eating, wearing. He wasn't dictating all of that. Let's look at Oprah Winfrey. She draws millions and millions of viewers across the globe, right? She grew up in a place that's predominantly known for white celebrities. She is so comfortable and pretty in her skin. Her smile, her confidence radiates, and that's being authentic. Let's look at our own Indira Nooyi. You think it would have been easy for her to not stand out because of the way she looked or her accent? I'm sure she didn't blend in because of that, but I'm sure she found 1,000 other ways to blend in or to even outshine the rest by her sheer work and hard work and focus on results. So that's what authentic leadership is all about. Let's look at some pitfalls of a person who's not authentic. If you're trying to be someone, if you're trying to put on a show, or you're trying to simply fit in by saying, yes, I know it, oh yeah, I've also done it, or sound different, or just be a part of the group. One, your stress levels are going to be very high. Your body language will give you away. People are not going to trust you as much as they would have had you just been yourself. You might also be a subject of mockery for a person who's trying to be someone he or she is not. You know, it's okay just the way you are. We all carry scars or burdens of our past. It could have been that someone laughed at you because of the way you looked back in school. Maybe you were a little plump and you were laughed at and you carry that scar today. Maybe someone joked about your dressing style. Maybe someone even joked about your accent. But so what? Those were jokes. We don't have to carry them with us. Let's be comfortable the way we are. Yes, that doesn't mean that you suddenly color your hair pink and you walk into office. Of course, you'll stand out for the wrong reasons. It doesn't mean that you walk to office in pajamas simply because you feel very comfortable in them. Of course, you have to do certain basic things so that you don't stand out for the wrong reasons. But be yourself. Love yourself the way you are. If you are a little overweight, not a problem as long as you're feeling fit, right? If you have a different accent, that should not hold you back. If you can't speak the local language with finesse, that's also not a reason to hold you back. Stay focused on the content. If you don't know something, stay hungry to learn. Let people know you haven't understood something. They'll respect you for your transparency and honesty. Never penalize anyone else simply because he looks or sounds different. respect people who come up and say, hey, I haven't understood this, or I need help because I've never done this before. And have the same yardstick for yourself. Love yourself the way you are and be less stressed. Be an authentic leader and inspire so many people out there. They'll be happy. They'll look up to you just because you're so down to earth. You are yourself. You're helping them reach their goals and you're reaching your own. So cherish yourself and your leadership style. I'd like to just say one last thing, especially to the women out there. You might feel differentiated against, but let me tell you one thing. It only happens when you carry the difference in your head. If you feel that you are different, you are going to give out the kind of energies or vibes that will make the men in the room feel that you are different. The minute you blend in because of your work, the minute you forget the difference that you are a woman in a group of 10 men sitting in a boardroom, they forget it too. The minute you start focusing on the real work out there and the business agenda, the same happens to you. That's also part of being yourself, being effective, and being focused to the task. So once again, just be yourself, be focused on the task, be an authentic leader.